They don't have any. But the pipe, I don't know what it's called right now, but the pipe that goes through the thing, the like exhaust pipe, it gets hot enough to where the car actually does get warm. There's no rear view, the mirror thing's on the side, but does have that one in the center. I kind of find it hard to get in because there's a door jam. There's a seat. It looks more awkward with actually trying to get in here. But does have the crank window. It has a lock, huge lock. Another weird thing is, you see there's a keyhole right here on this side, on the driver's side. But if you go over here on the passenger side, this is the only way, if you lock yourself out of the car, that's the only key. So it's on the passenger side instead of driver's. I don't really know why that is, though. Does have all original like spoke wheels, the wooden spokes, and actually right here, those are the hubcaps, these little metal things. Like mine, it fits the whole tire. I guess this thing was good in the snow because it does sit up really high and has narrow tires. So I guess that makes it good in the snow. But then again, when these cars came out, the roads back then were like dirt and mud and stuff, so they did have to trek through some like non-paved roads. And it's really cold out here, so that's why I'm breathing heavy. Does have a light. Doesn't open when you turn the door on. Actually has a switch, and that's right there. Does have a storage area, and it's underneath this seat. And the only seat belt it has would be a leather strap that hooks on to these hooks, and it'd be more like a roller coaster than anything. I don't know how that's a seat belt if you're in a head collision, but yes, it is. No turn signals, but this light right here goes to it's an aftermarket for Model A. Also, I guess on the Model A's, they finally decided that, well, in the gas tank's not in a very good place on this car, so they put one right here on the Model A. They found out later that that's way too close to the engine, so they finally started putting them back there. And here is a picture of the first snowmobile, and it took after the Model T. They didn't call it a snowmobile, I actually forget what they called it. But it was like a truck, kinda, and you could take off the skis and put on actual wheels. It does have a leather top, which is kinda falling apart, actually. Out there. I'm thinking I kind of cover everything I know about this car. I think it must have been crazy to actually ride in one of these back then. Although this thing does run, but needs a carburetor. It can make it right there where mine's at before it dies. But that's it. I'll probably try and make a video if we ever get it running this year before the snow comes. I got a new paint job on mine. My Mako. $650. But that's about it for the Model T that I know of.